As winter approaches and our energy bills rise, so does the risk of fire at home. Last year alone, there were nearly 11,000 house fires across the country, many of which, of course, were preventable. This week is Fire Prevention Week in New South Wales, and Fire and Rescue want us to make fire a safety priority. For more details on this potentially life-saving campaign, we're joined by Commissioner Greg Mullins from New South Wales Fire and Rescue in the studio. Commissioner, thank you for coming in this morning. The thing that you're really talking about in this fire, so as we lead up to the fire season in particular, is a safety audit of our homes. What are you talking about?
Look, Ron, we've got an online home fire safety audit. It's very easy to access, homefiresafetyaudit.com.au. It takes people through each room in the house, including the garage. They're asked simple questions, and at the end, you get a list of things that you can do to keep you and your family safe from fire.
The interesting thing is that winter is actually the time of year when fires, especially house fires, are at their peak. What are we doing wrong so often to cause that?
Look, unfortunately, right around Australia, firefighters dread the first cold day in winter because they know they're going to be run off their feet. Mm. People have got the heaters out, the electric blankets, they're cooking more, they're staying home. And all of those things carry risks with them. So open fires, heaters, drying clothes, too close to the heater, forgetting to clean the lint filter on the dryer. We get lots of fires because of that. And in the kitchen, that's the biggest danger area. Mm. People just forgetting they've got something on the stove.
We've sort of learnt the lesson. I think most of us, especially, well, obviously in new homes, but also in older homes, we are getting the message that we should be installing fire alarms. What else should we be doing?
Look, smoke alarms are essential, but unfortunately, even in New South Wales, where it's been the law for years, about 6% of households still don't have the alarms. And the other thing is, tragically, we still go to fires where people have been injured or killed and the batteries have been taken out of the alarms. Yeah. So we recommend that they be hardwired by an electrician, photoelectric alarms, interconnected so that they all go off if one goes off. But so the smoke alarms. The other thing is a home fire escape plan. You expect it when you come to work, and our research shows that if people get woken up at 3 a.m. by a smoke alarm and they're disorientated, sometimes they don't know how to get out.
How do we solve that problem? When you talk about a plan for evacuation or escape from your home, what do you need to set up?
Look, very simple. We ask people to look for two exits out of each room, and it might be a window, and if it's on an upper floor, there might need to be a plan of, okay, how do I get out of that window safely? So if they feel the door and it's hot and there's smoke coming out, that second exit. Mm. If there's kids or elderly who are mobility impaired, have a plan to help them out. And the big one is have a meeting place somewhere, usually the letterbox at the front of the house.
So you can do a count for everybody.
Yeah, and never go back in. Yeah. Dial 000. When the firefighters arrive, say, look, one person's missing. They're in this room.
I know there's been a bit of a scare campaign recently about the different types of smoke alarms. I mean, you can go down to your local hardware store and pick one up for about $10. Are they just as good, or is there a problem with those over the more expensive ones?
Look, there's two types of smoke alarms, and I won't go into a technical thing, but they're ionisation and photoelectric. The ionisation alarms have been available for decades. They're very simple technology. They're quite cheap. They're readily available. They're the cheaper ones. The photoelectric alarms, the technology wasn't so great years ago for domestics, so you couldn't get them for a start. Now they're coming down in price. The fire brigades and fire services around Australia do recommend the newer photoelectric alarms. But if you have the old one, they still work, but they might not be as quick as the photoelectric.
I know you and I have been talking about fires for the last 20 years and how to prevent them. You've got a new campaign out here in New South Wales. It looks good on TV, but is that how you can educate people? Are people getting the message?
Look, it's a confronting campaign. We have a couple of TV commercials, but it shows just how quickly a fire can spread in the home. And you have just minutes.
Yeah, we're just looking at that now. It's a very effective campaign. Also, you were talking about the home audit thing earlier when we began talking. You've got a website for that as well.
We do, homefiresafetyaudit.com.au. So we do ask families to do that. Now, the TV ad that we have, it is confronting. It shows what can happen. We've got a very brave young woman, Linda Buchan, who lost her sister in a fire and was severely injured herself about 12 years ago, and she wants to help us spread that fire safety message.
All right, let's see if we can make your job a little easier this year.
Thanks, Ron.
Commissioner Greg Mullins from New South Wales Fire.